In the next hour, 7:30 to 8:30, we do positional sparring and drilling. This is kind of like a training wheels type of scenario for doing jiu-jitsu. We're going to do live resistance training, but we're going to have confines in there that set you up to succeed. For example, when I started, I was told to kind of go off in the corner, go over there, do some sparring. I would get over there, and I didn't really know what I was doing, and my partners, a lot of times, they didn't know what they were doing either, and so we kind of made stuff up along the way. The idea with positional sparring is that we set boundaries and starting points and stopping points so that you can practice the moves that we're learning in the curriculum. If we're practicing from side control, we start in side control. I give you a set of goals, you know, submit or get to mount. And if you get there, you start over. If you don't get there, which is very common because maybe you're not good at these moves, then when you fail at that and maybe you get reversed, you don't have to spend 4 or 5 minutes on bottom. When I was coming up, I remember learning a mounted armbar, and I really wanted to get this armbar. So I spin out for the armbar, and I fall to the bottom because I'm not good at it. The guy defends. There are consequences for that. You know, somebody comes up on top of me, they lay on top of me. It can be really frustrating, and it doesn't really foster a learning environment because I have to deal with the consequence of not being good at the armbar. So now the next time I get in that position, I have an opportunity to do an armbar again. Sometimes I don't take that opportunity because I'm afraid of the consequence. With positional sparring, I give you the opportunity, or I give you the ability to try that armbar without paying the consequence. And that's really important because then you don't develop bad habits because you're afraid of consequences. In between the positional sparring, there is transitional drills. I teach you how to move your body. A lot of times people practice sweeps and submissions, but they don't practice escapes or transitions. Transitions are really important, but they're kind of boring. We do them in a fast-paced scenario where you get to work your cardio in a way that is relative and transfers to jiu-jitsu, but also while building important motor movements for being successful in jiu-jitsu. Next round, positional sparring, starting in half guard. Person on bottom, you have the underhook. Pass, sweep, or submit. When I say pass, that means all guards, not just half guard. If you go to closed guard, keep on going. You have to pass guard completely.
Shane Seegers, blue belt, 39 years old.
BJJ interested me because, as my wife says, I am a MMA groupie, so I really love the UFC, and BJJ is so closely related to wrestling. BJJ is one of those things where you either like it or you don't almost. You find very few people that do it just to stay in shape. There's so many other avenues and means to get in shape. So with wrestling and BJJ being so related, it interested me.
Well, I wanted to be an MMA fighter, so it was important for me to have skills on the ground as, you know, to complement my boxing and kickboxing.
Really just to get in shape and just keep myself active. You know, I know martial arts is very good at not only conditioning yourself and challenging yourself mentally, but also mentally as far as remembering techniques and moves. And then also challenges yourself physically as far as getting yourself in condition and staying in shape.
As you come up.
And then drop your bottom, Patrick. There you go. Next round, positional sparring, starting knee on belly. Person on top, you're looking to maintain the positive position and secure a submission. That means if you do not want to stay in knee on belly, you may immediately transition to another positive position. North, south, side control, back, mouth. Keep going, keep in the positive position and secure a submission. Person on bottom, you're looking to get back to any neutral position. That means anything with the word guard in it. If you go to turtle, that is supposedly a neutral position, but here we continue going. If you get to your feet, start back over. Make sense? Good, no one's gonna ask me the rules now, right?
No, sir.
All right, any type of guard, start back over. Get ready.
Cox. I'm 40 years old next month, and I'm a blue belt. I had been sitting around for probably 7 to 8 years, you know, getting fat, getting out of shape, and I knew I needed to do something, and this seemed like a pretty likely way to get in shape, and it certainly has been.
My name is Jason Dayton. I am a white belt, and I'm 34 years old. Originally, it was to get back in shape. I had put on some weight after college and during college, and I needed something that was high intensity and was going to take some of those pounds off.
My name is Derek Dale Barker. My age, I am 33, and I am a two-stripe purple belt. Something else to do besides lifting weights. It allowed me to kind of exercise the demons, get a good workout in, and it was fun, exciting, and new. That was my original intent. I didn't really have any intentions. It was just something new to try.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is really different than all the other sports in the fact that you can do it to fit your needs. You know, if you want to be a hardcore competitor, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu can provide that depth for you. If you want to be a casual person that just uses it as recreation, maybe more just on the side, you know, like 2 or 3 nights a week, you can get enjoyment out of that. You can still develop skills and be able to apply those skills. If you want to do it for self-defense, you know, it's great for that as well. Through all my times bouncing, I think I closed fist hit one guy. And I'd been doing a lot of kickboxing and boxing, so every time that it came down to using skills that I had acquired throughout my martial arts career, I found myself always resorting to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. If you want to be an MMA fighter, it's important that you train some type of groundwork, and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is, I would think, the most comprehensive. You know, it works off your back, it works on top. You know, it has more depth than anything else that I've seen.
Get out of your comfort zone, one. There's different types of being in shape or being physical. We have runners who come in here and just simply running, and they're exhausted after rolling for 1 8-minute round. When you're actually rolling, you incorporate not only your cardiovascular, but the muscle endurance and everything. So you have to learn when to press the gas pedal, when to stop, and that comes with time.
So I first heard about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and when UFC 1 happened, I was in college and remember, you know, Hoist kicking butt. And I always thought it was kind of interesting. Aikido has some background with Jiu-Jitsu as far as their parent arts, so I thought it would be kind of a good addition, but it's been great.
I think it's a great way. I mean, I'm probably in the best shape of my life, even better shape than when I took karate. I've lost 30 pounds over the time period of 2 years, and it's just a lot of fun. It's very interesting. It's very challenging, like I said, mentally and physically, and it's just a great, great experience, and it's a great way to get yourself in shape. It's interesting. It's just not going in and doing a routine or working out. I mean, you're actually being challenged every class, and I think that just adds to your growth, not only getting yourself in shape, but also keeping yourself in shape.
Well, it was very close to wrestling. it allowed for hand-to-hand combat, something which I've always been partial to and I'm kind of good at. So it was an avenue where in a controlled environment, basically get into a fight and not get hit in the face, like not getting hit in the face.
It's fun. That's probably the best reason. It's a really good time. You wouldn't necessarily think so, rolling around with a bunch of other guys and sweating and working hard, but it's a great time. It's a great group of people, very little ego. You know, I can't say enough good things about it. It's really a pleasure to be in here.
Nine. Wind up.